भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। हरिओम एंड नमस्कार टू एवरीवन। व्हेन समवन ग्रीट्स यू, व्हाट डू यू डू? कैन वी ऑल डू दैट, ग्रीट बैक? हरिओम एंड नमस्कार टू एवरीवन। नाउ वी लूज ऑल दीज। ओके, नॉट ओनली नमस्कार टू ऑल ऑफ यू हु आर इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी, फॉर दोज हु आर अटेंडिंग द ई सेशंस ऑल्सो, नमस्कार टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सनातन धर्म हैज फोर बेसिक स्क्रिप्चर्स। एनीथिंग दैट आई से एंड टचेज योर हार्ट, प्लीज नोट इट। एनीथिंग यू फील दैट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर, प्लीज नोट इट, बिकॉज वी टेंड टू फॉरगेट। द वॉल्यूम शुड बी हायर, keep it at the same volume that I want. Hari Om. Hari Om. Sorry. Hari Om. Hari Om. Hari Om. Ha. Fine. I think that's fine. Yeah. So, four basic scriptures are there of the Sanatan Dharma, which are they? So it is said, the first is called Shruti. Shruti, in other words, is Vedas. Many of you have heard Vedant and all, you may have heard this, but it is always good to revise and understand, because each time your understanding can deepen. The Vedas are called Shruti. Char Mukhya Shastra hai Sanatan Dharma ke. पहला है श्रुति, द वेदर्स आर रिवील्ड नॉलेज। देर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन रिवील्ड नॉलेज एंड डिस्कवर्ड नॉलेज। न्यूटन डिस्कवर्ड द लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटी, it was not revealed to him. Okay, it was what? Discovered. Archimedes, please can tell you me. I want you all of you, when I ask a question, I want you to answer. Ask Archimedes, what did he do? Discovered the law of flotation. Okay, he discovered. It was not revealed to him. But the entire Vedas, they were not discovered knowledge, they are what? Revealed knowledge. It was shown to them, if I have to say it. They saw it. Saw means not eyes. You know, when I tell you something and you understand, you say, I see, I see. Do you see with your eyes? How do you see? You're understanding that type of hum kehte hain, ha samjhe samjhe. So you, they saw this knowledge, they discovered, not they didn't discover, they saw this, it was revealed to them. You know, there's a very beautiful movie of Srinivas Ramanuja, The Law of Everything, something, I think that's the name of the movie, The Proof of Everything, ha, some name like that. You must see it if you haven't seen it. It's an English movie. It's beautiful. See, Srinivas Ramanuja is an Indian, went to the UK, and there, one of the best colleges, he was there. Mathematics was his forte, he used this, and he used to give the In just like that, he used to just tell them the final, you know, proof of things. Just the conclusions. And he just came out. And then they would ask, they would not accept, because the Western style is, as I told you, what? So step by step, they would say, give the proof of it. How did you come to this conclusion? They said, I know the final answer. I know this formula. I know how it works. How did you arrive at it? He's saying, I know. And he used to say that he was an upasaka of a devi. He says, she showed it to me. Now you think such an answer will work in the UK? They said, what are you mad or what? What are you talking? But what used to happen, it used to take them months and years to come to the conclusion he just said like that. You understand? And for him, the proof used to come afterwards, the step-by-step proof. He used to then do it also for satisfying what? Others. But for him, the final thing used to come. He would just get the whole thing just like that, perfect. There were so many such formulas that he got, which even to date, they are still trying to find what? Because he just had them. He used to say, this is it, this is this, this is the way, it will only be this. It cannot be anything else. Now you are understanding what I meant by intuition and all of that? He was a Devi Upasaka. And he used to sit there and it used to come to him. So this is called what knowledge? Huh? Revealed knowledge. It can happen, as I told you, upasana and sadhana. So this is, the shrutis were all what knowledge? Revealed knowledge. So the sages, rishi, apne dhyan avastha mein, to unka laboratory kya tha? Laboratory? It could be anywhere. They are sitting somewhere in their ashram, maybe in their kutya, maybe in the forest, maybe wherever. And they would just sit there, and this body was their equipment with which they would experiment and they would get. And then the truth of it, they would experiment with their own body. That is why charaka and all of that, you know, so many things they found. Medicines, if you say, and who was the one who found so much? Sushruta. So many equipments and all. How did it come to them? This was revealed to them, and then they used to experiment with actually people and everything, and then say, yes, this is it, this is it. So, this is called Shruti. And why is it called Shruti? Because from Guru to Shishya, it was given. It was heard, given, and then the next generation of students got it, etc. Now, what happened? In the process of giving, a lot of it was lost. How was it lost? Very simple way. Supposing the guru had 50 truths that he has discovered, it was revealed to him, he would teach, let us say maybe 40, because the student would be only capable of learning 40, let's say. Understood? The teacher, every knowledge and all the understanding, he can't teach, even if he wants to. It will be not possible. So let's say he taught 40 of it. From the 40 truths that he discovered, he got revealed, the students, some of them had the capacity to experiment and understand the truth of, let's say, 25. So their shishyas, when they gave probably 20. Others, they just gave like that, because my guru has said this, he'll just have said, but not have experimented and seen the truth of it. Is it okay? Then some others would just get lost in time. Some would get carried forward, and therefore in time this knowledge was seen to in different places all over Bharata Varsha, as they call it. It is extended Bharat. It was not only in this what we understand as India, because Afghanistan was part of Bharat. Are you aware of that? That Kandahar was what? Gandhar. Gandhari came from there, Gandhar. All this was all part of the great Bharatvarsha. So anyway, now Vedavyasa, Bhagavan Vedavyasa, he was considered as an avatar only of Bhagavan. He realized that this will get lost in time, and therefore what did he do? He became the compiler cum editor of the Vedas. What? Who was he? Compiler. He did not compose. This is the difference. This is not composed knowledge. This is revealed knowledge. Are you understanding the difference between the two? He did not compose it. He what? Compiled it. And imagine the great work that he did. We call him Vedavyasa. His name is what? Vyasa. But we call him what? Vedavyasa. So many times people say, who wrote the Vedas? Then they'll say, Vedavyasa. So did he write the Vedas? Yes. Did he compose the Vedas? No. And he himself was so great that when he compiled it and brought it together, it was not just knowledge which was there. For him, all of it was revealed knowledge. In the sense, he had experimented and seen the truth himself. Is that okay? And put it. He was not something that's lost knowledge without him experimenting and seeing the truth. He just wrote it down because it's available somewhere. I hope you're understanding the difference. Yes. So he compiled. And when he compiled it into what? Four volumes. So how many Vedas are there? One Veda. How many volumes are there? Four volumes. Have you understood this? So when people ask, now see what happens now, we are all Sanatan Dharma, we call ourselves Hindus also, but our basic things are what? Not understood. So how many Vedas? How many volumes? What are the four volumes? Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda, and Atharva Veda. So the Rig Veda is more or less in all the mantras are as prose. Yajur Veda is more a metrical Gadya, and the other is what? In a Padya, in a metrical this. Sama Veda is as songs. That is why they say the Sama Gana. And Atharva Veda is a mixture. More or less, huh? It's not that you don't get some this in. Many of the mantras are, the same mantras are there in the, what? Rig Veda, you also find in other Vedas also. Like, the, for example, the Purusha Suktam. Purusha Suktam you find in the Rig Veda also, in the other Vedas also. They consider the Rig Veda as the oldest and the Atharva Veda as the last. Okay. And that is why the Vedic, now how do you bring this Vedic knowledge to people? How is it, you know, the same? So they made it into a metrical composition. You know, like they had what is called swaras. For those of you, you know, in the book also some places there will be swaras. So there will be one line on the top, there will be one dash in the bottom. You see some of this. So when it goes up, that line on the top means you take up. Then when it goes up, it goes down. And there's nothing, it's like in between. Swarita. Udatta, Anudatta, Swarita. In these only three, the entire Vedas are there. And that is why from north to south, when you chant, it will be the same. However, there are certain styles, you will say, no, North India, they do it differently. The Yajur Veda, for example, is chanted differently in North India and South India. Then you say, what is this? Why? So, there are two aspects or two parts of the Yajur Veda. One is called Shukla Yajur Veda and one is called Krishna Yajur Veda. So North India, you have what? Shukla Yajurveda, and in South India, the chanting is according to Krishna Yajurveda. So you'll find sometimes so-called differences in pronunciations as well. Now I'll show you a little difference of the two, so you'll understand, are ha, north mein aise kaate hai. And south mein the pandits do it like that. For example, in the south, how do we chant? Om Sahasra Shirsha Purushah Sahasraksha Sahasrapat Sabhumim Vishvato Vritva Atyatishthat Dashangulam. Okay. Now in South India, there will be mantras. Om Shantirantarikshagam Shantir Pruthavi Shantirapah Shanti Okhadayah Shantir. You see the difference? You'll find in North India. Okha, they say. Oshadayah, they will say Okha. Purukha, they will say. Because that's the style. It's not that they're doing wrong, okay? Are you understanding? This is the swaras will be like that. And then they will put their hand like that, like that. Have you seen them doing with their hand? The hand is for that swaras. So they learn it and they do it. In the south also, when some of the pandits will be standing, they will, because when they have to learn the this, no, they don't know. So up, na? So they'll say, Om Sahasra Shisha Purusha Purusha, because going down, Sahasra Shisha. Okay, so the entire, this was maintained. So all of us, when we learn also, we learn it exactly in the same way. So any group of people starting Purusha Suktam, same way they will chant it. Okay, so if we want to chant the Vedas, either we should chant it with the right swaras or chant it without swaras. Please don't chant with the wrong swaras. Is that okay? If you chant it without swaras also, it is fine. Om Sahasra Shirsha Purushah Sahasraksha Sahasrapat Sabhumim Vishvato Vritva Atyatishthat Dashangulam. That is fine. Because these swaras and this particular way of composition itself creates certain vibrations. If a person is really well-tuned, just by listening, even if they have not heard the chanting before, just if they tune up, they will know. Something is wrong with the swaras. Why? Because it's not creating the right vibration in my mind or in my body. This is how they will know. I know of a saint who, even if he has not heard a particular mantra, he'll just sit there and he'll say, I think in this particular place, you should take it up, not down. Check it out. And it will be exactly as he. Why? Because he is seeing these had certain vibrations. So he says, something is wrong. It's not right. Are you with me? So this is how this great knowledge was preserved over centuries. So what is the timeline for this? They say anywhere between what? 5,000 and 10,000 years before Christ. Okay, how much? What is the timeline? No one can say exact. So how old are the Vedas? So this knowledge was there before that or not? Bolo, bolo. Before that also it was there. The compiled thing is between this, so you can imagine. Now we are talking about that. And at that time, if you see the type of things that were there, of knowledge of every possible type, there is knowledge, if you see Chandogya Upanishad, there is knowledge of furniture design. There is also talk, if you see the other Upanishads, there is talk of nail cutters. What? There's talk of what? All types of makeup. You name it. Cooking, ghee, ye wo, so many things. Cooking, puris, ye sab. Puris are that old. Can you imagine? So a thousand years. See, we have no idea what is there inside our word. Puri is not there. What I'm trying to tell you is what? That this knowledge is what? So ancient. We as Indians, should we know of all this or not? Please tell me. When, because we don't know anything, we are not proud. Proud, I don't mean in the wrong way. I mean, we're not, we don't have that pride in what we stand for. And we think everything only came from where? The West. We forget the glory of what we were, what we are. Okay, so now, what knowledge is it? Revealed knowledge, Shruti. Ye kya hai? जो ध्यानस्थ अवस्था में ये ज्ञान प्राप्त किया और उससे क्या जो गुरु परंपरा से ये हमारे तक आया है इस ज्ञान को हम क्या कहते हैं वेद कहते हैं एंड ऑल द वर्ड्स ऑफ द वेदर्स आर कॉल्ड मंत्रस जो भी शब्द राशि है वेद की उसको क्या कहते हैं मंत्र कहते हैं उसको श्लोक नहीं कहते हैं उसको क्या कहते हैं मंत्र It's called the mantras. Right? More of it we'll see when we actually start the Upanishad. Then we have the second type of knowledge which is called Smriti. Normally we call it remembered knowledge because Smriti, Smaranam is what? Remembered. It doesn't mean remembered means what you hear and remember. No. It means that whatever knowledge is in the Vedas. Remember the Vedas are the basic fundamental Moola Shastra. The Moola Shastra is only the Vedas. And as far as we are concerned, in our scriptures also it is said, any knowledge in line with the Vedas is acceptable. If it is not in line with the Vedas, it is not acceptable as a Shastra. Are you understanding? If the knowledge is not in line with the Vedas, and then it is given, it is called Nasti. Nastika Mata. Nastika Mata. See, we think Nastik and Astik means what? Astik means those who believe in God. And Nastik means those who don't believe in God. Hum aise mante hai na? Ki Nastik kaun hote hai? Jo Bhagwan mein nahi mante hai. Aur Astik kaun hote hai? Jo Bhagwan mein mante hai. Here there is nothing like that. We in the Vedantic parampara and all, we believe what? Astik is one who believes in the Vedas and Nastik is one who does not believe in the Vedas. Have you understood? Vedas is the authentic means of knowledge. So any scripture in line with the Vedas is considered authentic. If it's not in line with the Vedas, we do not consider it authentic, whoever it be who has revealed it. Is it okay, everyone? Now, having understood this, we have the Smritis. Smritis are knowledge where great saints, great people, having understood the Vedas, made it simpler in terms of its application or in its day-to-day living. So the emphasis was more on the dharma. Okay, I must tell this only, then it's easily understood. The two main topics of the Vedas is dharma and brahma. I'm using the word dharma, actually it can be covered, dharma covers the words brahma also, but just for the sake of understanding, I'm giving these two different words. What is it? The main topics of the Veda is what? Dharma and brahma. All other things, as I told you, all these other things are all by the by. That is not the purpose of the Vedas. The purpose of the Vedas is dharma and that which cannot be known through what? Human mind is the purpose of the Vedas. All the other things which can be known through the human mind is by the by. Is it okay? That which cannot be understood, cannot be known, jo manushya man se nahi jana ja sakta hai, wahi ved ka prayojan hai. Isliye usko apaurusheya kehte hain. एक तो जो पुरुष ने बनाया नहीं है इसलिए और दूसरा कि वो मनुष्य बुद्धि से ये ज्ञान प्राप्त नहीं किया जा सकता है इसलिए उसको क्या कहते हैं अपौरुषेय कहते हैं मीनिंग व्हाट फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग नाउ व्हेन आई क्लैप माय हैंड मैं जब ताली बजाती हूँ तो क्या होता है साउंड कम्स राइट. नाउ ये हम रूम में हैं और मैंने ताली बजाई. सो द नेट रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस क्लैप एंड द साउंड दैट इट क्रिएट्स इन दिस एंटायर रूम, कैन इट बी कैलकुलेटेड, यस और नो? द नेट रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस क्लैप इन दिस पर्टिकुलर हॉल ओनली, कैन इट बी कैलकुलेटेड, यस और नो? नो. व्हाई इट कैन नॉट बी कैलकुलेटेड? बिकॉज देर आर टू many factors in play. Are you understanding? Because in your laboratory, in a controlled environment with that tuning fork in a particular pressure, everything, then you can give the exact result that comes. Is it true or not? But here there are too many surfaces, too many variables. Is it true or not? Even the best of equipment that science can possibly have can never give this calculation. They will only give an approximate calculation of the net result of this. Are you understanding? How many surfaces are there? Please tell me. Innumerable. And then the heat and this, and so many factors are there. So exact, it will never be there. Approximately possible. Even the most advanced instruments of this present advanced time cannot give the calculation of that. Now imagine a simple thing like actually one simple action like clapping and sound cannot perfect result. Then an action that I do with hundreds and thousands of variable factors and how it will happen, with what mind I do, with what intention I do, how can you calculate the exact result of that? Are you understanding? You will need a super computer. And that super computer we call God. Are you understanding? We say no, karmaphal who gives? Right. So exact this result comes to that person in their own time when it has to come in a particular way, etc. Is it possible to calculate all this in human this mind? No. Too many variables, too many lifetimes. Which lifetime, which karma, how you did, when you did, how it came, impossible. So these type of topics which are there, which is not possible to calculate with human intellect, is the topic of the Vedas. Is that okay? So one is called Dharma and the other is called Brahma. Both these topics you cannot with the human mind. That is the topic. Now simple understanding of what is Dharma and Brahma, simple. Dharma is that which helps us to live a good life here and hereafter. Is janma aur uske piche jo janma aate hain achhi tarah se sukh se maximum kya kehte hain productive ya progressive dhang se reh sakte hain, is vishay ko dharma kehte hain. Iha lok परलोक सुधारने का ज्ञान है, इसको धर्म कहते हैं. आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? सिंपल. यस. इट इंप्रूव्स अवर लाइफ हियर एंड हियर आफ्टर. इट डजंट जस्ट टॉक ऑफ हियर, इवन हियर आफ्टर. एम आई मेकिंग सेंस टू ऑल ऑफ यू? एंड दैट विच फ्रीज अस from the year and hereafter is called Brahma. जो हमें इहलोक परलोक से मुक्त करने का ज्ञान है इसको ब्रह्म कहते हैं, ब्रह्म ज्ञान कहते हैं. Have you understood? That liberates us from the year and hereafter. That is called Brahma. So these are the two topics of the Vedas. Now the smritis, the emphasis is not on the brahmagnana. It is not that there is no brahmagnanam, but the emphasis is on dharmagnanam. Have you understood now the difference? Because it's more easy for a day to, how do I live? When do I get up in the morning? Now, for example, all of you also, you came and Yes, the japa, what it does in the mind and all that, I did explain, but finally you had a question. What? How do I hold my mala? Isn't it true? After all the things that I spoke, your whole thing was what? How do I hold my... Aya ki nahi us par, bolo. How do I hold my mala? Should I put it like that? Should I put it on the ground? Should I face this there? Should I... Isn't it true? So I had to give so much talk, not on the theory of the japa and all, but more was what? You sit like that, don't sit like that, get up like that, walk your leg that, you put your leg there, don't put your leg there, up and down. Isn't it true? So what knowledge I gave more? The philosophy or the basic how to do it? You get the point. You take one bead and then once mala is over, you put like, I do teach. Then how to do exact, how to do exact? Arey Rama, you say your mantra and say swaha. No, but tell me how, whether I'm doing it right. Aye, Baba, take na this little whatever is there and just say, Om Namah Shivaya, swaha, like that you do. You remember, even if I had told you everything, your question will be about what? Are you with me? So I had to tell you that now. So that, so to speak. So the smritis emphasize on that. Is it okay? It's not that they don't talk about the Brahmagnana. They do talk about the Brahmagnana, but all this. For example, let's take the Bhagavad Gita. If you see in the Bhagavad Gita, it is not that Brahmagnanam is not talked about. Aham Atma Guda Keshaha Sarva Bhuta Ashaya Sthitaha. It is talked. Brahmagnanam is talked about. But most of the time, what are they talking about? Ama nitvam adam bhitvam mahinsa kshantira. So what? Values of life. And then if you do this karma, you know, kshine punye martya loke vishanti. When you do, you go to swarga. And then when your punya is over, you come back from swarga. All these things are said in the Bhagavad Gita. So some of you who are familiar with Gita, you know that majority of the verses are talking about what? Dharmagnana or Brahmagnanam? Dharmagnanam. It is not that Brahmagnana is not talked. That's why it said Brahma Vidya is there. But it's along with the, you know, if the end of the each chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, what is said? Om Tat Sat Iti Srimad Bhagavad Gita Su Upanishad Su. Each is called Upanishad. Brahma Vidya Yam. What is the knowledge? Brahma Vidya. But the next word is very important. Yoga Shastre means what? How to connect to this. Meaning the Dharma Gnanam is also given. Is it okay? Gita is considered as a smriti. Then the very, very famous one is Manusmriti. There are other smritis also, but let's say these two we can have as the main smriti. Gita and what? Manusmriti. Manusmriti gives more details. Get up at this time, early morning, get up and do this like that. So gives lots more details about all these things of how to live, you know, do your dharma. Okay? So that is what? Smriti. Then the next one will be what? Purana. I'll talk about itihas. The fourth is itihas. I'll talk about itihas first. We consider two as our itihasas, shastras. Which are the two? Ramayana and Mahabharata. Now, what is the difference between itihas and Purana? So, the same knowledge that is there in the Vedas, the same knowledge that is there in the Smritis also, but through stories and symbolism and lot of, you know, examples. Like when I also talk, I told you about Tukaram story and this one story and Janavan. Did I or not? Then what happened? The same knowledge became easy. If it was only theory, what would happen without examples? It will not go home. So therefore the Puranas and the Itihasas made it all into what? Easy to understand. I always remember my history teacher. I used to hate that subject in school because a history teacher made it so boring. But then in a particular class when I came, the history teacher changed. And she would make the whole this come alive. You would feel that the king has there come and, you know, you actually picturize the whole thing. And all overnight history became my favorite subject. Otherwise, only dates. And that you have to, 1857, Battle of Plassey. You, Rama. See, I still remember that date. Did you not have all that type of thing? Just mugging dates, and it is so boring, unbelievably. So, Puranas and Itihas do, what do? They make this entire, the same knowledge. Huh? The knowledge is the knowledge of the Vedas. But there is a story, there's symbolism, there's examples. And then you start imagining Rama has come and then Ravana comes and you get so this. And then before you know, through the Rama and Ravana, they are telling you what? How to kill your ego, how to realize the Brahman, etc. Are you understanding? Then what is the difference between Itihas and Purana? Because both of them tell stories. So, Itihasa means Itihasa. Thus, it is said. We all know all stories, how do they start and end? Once upon a time, it is heard. Isn't it true? That's how we start. Once upon a time. Thus, it is said. Itihasa. Now, the Western way of understanding Itihasa and the Indian way of understanding Itihasa is different. Now, I want all of you to understand all these things. Why? Because we are so, our education has always been British in India because we were for so many years under the British rule. So, we've forgotten the understanding of our own knowledge in our way. Let me explain this to you. For us, history is not about dates, not about chronology. Chronology is there. Dates is there. But for us, that is not of primary importance. For us, the lessons that we learn from history is more important. Are you understanding? What? The lessons we learn from history is more important. Hamare liye itihas, kram ki baat kram hai. अनेक कहानियां है, क्रम है, सब कुछ है, लेकिन उसमें से हमको क्या सीखना है उस पर भार है. दूसरी सब चीज पर हमारा इतना भार नहीं होता है. सो व्हाट डू वी फाइंड? दैट वी विल फाइंड दैट सो एंड सो किंग वाज देयर, ही हैड 10 चिल्ड्रन. देन दे विल नॉट टॉक अबाउट 9 ऑफ देम बिकॉज दे हैड नथिंग टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट इन एनी वे. So they will talk about the 10th one. Oh, 10th one, he was, either he's very bad, then they'll talk, or he's very good, then they'll talk. Is it true or not? In between, that is a fact also. Which is the teacher you remember? Either very good teacher or very bad. Do you remember anyone in between? No, it's not possible. In life also, whom do you remember? So many people, thousands must have come, you must have forgotten all about them. Your classmates also, someone who troubled you a lot, you will definitely remember. Someone who was very good to you, you remember. Yes or no? So similarly, in this also, Itihasa, what would they give us? The good guys and the bad guys. We want to put it in as simple terms as that. And the lessons from which they came. Like Prithviraja was a great Raja. How his kingdom was ruled, what are the rules he gave, how he taught his praja about dharma, so many things about the rules, what are the rules that the king must follow. For Rama, Rama, and you can learn how two brothers must live together, how brother relation of brothers, how a husband wife relation should be there, etc., etc., etc. So, about life, about relationship, about duties, about so many things about dharma and also about Brahma. You know, Ananda Ramayana I was reading, and what a fantastic way Bhagwan Rama taught Sita Ji Brahma Jnana. It's given. Bhagwan Rama taught Kaushalya Brahma Jnana. It's given. It's very interesting. The way he taught each of them was very different. He taught the citizens of Ayodhya Dharma Jnana. How he taught? Are you understanding? So for us that was important. Itihasa. Still, what is the difference between Itihasa and Purana? We shall see tomorrow. मजा आई कि नहीं आई? हाँ, तो इसलिए ऑल ऑफ यू, आई वॉन्ट यू ऑल टू प्लीज नोट डाउन ऑल दीज थिंग्स, अंडरस्टैंड, यू नो, बिकॉज समटाइम्स इवन वेन दे हियर इट ना, वी आर नॉट एबल टू टेल इट टू अदर्स, सो इट रिमेन्स विथ वॉट चेस. सो आई वॉन्ट यू ऑल टू बी एबल टू, ऑल मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट गोज अराउंड एंड ऑल दैट, वी डोंट स्पीक अप एट ऑल. We feel, why should we say no? And the wrong people are doing enough good prachar. Is it true or not? And we don't want to open our mouth. How can they? I don't know enough. Are Rama, they don't know anything and they are saying, and we know enough, but we don't say yes or no. Because we are Mahapurushas. All our Hindus are Mahapurushas only. I always say Hindus are Mahapurushas. Okay, anyway, so we will see tomorrow. ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः. हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः. हरिः ओम्.